drives it into right center field, hit a ton. This baby is way back. Otter here.
What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Hun Baby Baseball Channel. This is Eric, and today we got to recap the San Francisco Giants' first couple days of the draft, the first 10 rounds, where most likely most of the big-time players are going to be who are going to eventually play for the San Francisco Giants. Probably they're going to be scattered around those first 10 rounds, most of them. Not all, but most. So we got to talk about these guys because they could have an impact, especially the number one pick. But what I'm most excited about is the Giants draft. 9 pitchers. Like, I wanted them to go pitcher heavy every year. I'm like, let's get some pitchers in that system. But I know sometimes big league teams and, you know, their front offices, they just say, you know what, we're going to take the best available. We're not doing this for need. It's not about need. But fans like myself were like, no, we need X. And in this case, pitching. Our minor league system has a lot of great position players, but we seem to lack really good pitchers. We have a few, but we would love to really get some pitchers in there. Besides, you know, we think back to our World Series run there. Matt Cain, Tim Lincecum, Sergio Romo, Mad Bum, so on and so on. Jonathan Sanchez, and the list goes on and on and on. All those guys that helped us to win those World Series were homegrown pitchers. We did have a few homegrown players, of course, with Crawford and Belt and Posey. Those guys are still here. But we would love to draft some pitchers, and the Giants went above and beyond.
They went crazy with the pitchers.
And I'm loving it. So let's talk about these guys, starting with the first pick, the first round pick for the Giants. I was a little surprised. There was guys I wanted Jordan Wicks, but you know what? This might be even better. The Giants take Will Bednar out of Mississippi State at the 14th overall pick. This right-hander, 6'2", 229. He's got all the pitches that you want. Plus slider, hard curve, he can hit 97. He's got everything, and every pitch is above average. But what I really like about this guy, not just that he pounds the zone, not just that he has great control and great stuff, but he pitches with confidence and intelligence, and he's got great composure. And I saw some of his interviews, and I love this kid. He just sounds, you know, really smart, really well spoken. And he's got the stuff. He just feels like a Giant to me. And his stuff resulted in 135 strikeouts in just 86.1 innings. And he went 8-1. He's a winner. He gives his team a chance to win every time he takes the ball. Durable, strong, smart, and he has all the makings of a big league quality arm. And that is Bednar. I'm so happy with that pick. And then we move to the second round the next day. And the Giants, with the 50th overall pick, get Matt Mikulski, left-handed pitcher, another college arm that just shot up the prospect boards over the past year. He is a power pitcher. He's got a delivery that has been described as violent. Scouts do worry about his mechanics and control, which he has cleaned up a lot this year, to the tune of a 9-0 record and 1.45 ERA in the NCAA Atlantic 10 Conference. So the stats are there. I mean, he's been unhittable. And in 68 innings of work, he struck out an insane 124 batters, and he walked just 27. So whatever weirdness you see in his delivery, I mean, it's not showing through with the stats. And with 4 years of college experience, he can move through the minors quickly. And whether he's a starter or reliever, the potential is sky high for Matt Mikulski. I love this pick as well. And then we move on to the third round, and it's right-handed pitcher Mason Black out of Lehigh, 6'3", 235. His best pitch is his fastball, which has touched triple digits consistently around 94 to 97. He also has an 87-mile-an-hour above-average slider. Needs a little bit more consistency, but it is devastating when it's on. And he struck out 95 and 72 at Lehigh, which is in the NCAA Patriot League. He has the size, he has the durability to be a starter, but if that doesn't pan out, he's certainly a candidate to be a solid relief pitcher and just needs a little bit of work on his delivery, his consistency, his secondary pitches, but he's got the velocity, the arm strength, the size, all the ingredients you look for, and that's Mason Black. Then we move on to the fourth round, and the Giants take right-handed pitcher Eric Silva. He is currently committed to UCLA, but if he decides to sign with the Giants, they'll have another pitcher with another outstanding fastball. This is a fastball that went from the low 90s earlier in his high school career, and now he's touching 97. It's only getting faster, and scouts are watching it to see if it continues to improve. And he's got secondary pitches that miss bats as well. So the Giants took a chance on a high school kid here. He's got a great changeup. His command is a little questionable, but he will be able to work on that in the minors if he signs. So this is another kid. He's already got the stuff. It's simply a matter of improving his control and mechanics. Eric Silva, another guy to keep an eye on, fourth round pick for the Giants. And then maybe the most fun pick of the entire draft. This is Rohan Handa, left-handed pitcher, another college arm, 6'3", 210, big guy. But he had a fastball that was nothing special. It was around 85 miles an hour, and he still was a very good pitcher. Early in his college career, he had a good slider. He could locate. He keeps batters off balance. All of that, he was fine. He probably wasn't going to be drafted or anything like that. But then he said, you know what? Screw this. I'm going to totally revamp my mechanics. I need more velocity. And he improved it to 97 miles an hour. And he became unhittable. In five starts this year, he struck out 25 and 17 with a 0.53 ERA. He's still got that slider with plus spin rate. He locates his pitches. He limits walks. And most important, he already has a Hall of Fame mustache, okay? Look at that. This dude has got it all. Rohan Handa. This seems to be a great pick with tremendous upside, a great find for the Giants, and I'm so excited to see what he can do. Rohan Handa, lefty, and that is the fifth round pick. And then we move on to the sixth round, lefty out of Ohio State. And this is a name I've heard before, Seth Lonsway. He was a fairly big name earlier in his college career. He led Division I baseball in strikeouts in 2020. He's got a great curve that rates 65 out of 80. He struck out 17 batters against Indiana at one point in one game. So why was he picked so, you know, relatively low? Well, unfortunately, he does struggle with command. He has a delivery that is considered odd or weird, and his mechanics do go out of whack at times, and he walks too many guys. He walked 43 and 68. That's why he had a 4.37 ERA, but the good news is he controls his curveball very well. That's his best pitch, and he struck out 98 and 68. He's got the strikeout ability. The Giants are simply betting that he cleans up those mechanics and that he drastically improves his control, and if that happens, Seth Lonsway could end up being a steal and a really good big league pitcher. But if not, he probably won't even make it to the bigs. So we'll just have to keep an eye on him in his minor league career. Bringing us to right-handed pitcher out of Maine, Nick Sinicola. And the last pitcher I remember out of Maine for the Giants, there may have been others, but the last I remember was Bill Swift, who won 20 games for the Giants in 93. Giants didn't draft him, but he was really good for us. And he was out of Maine. And now we have Nick Sinicola, right-handed pitcher, 6'1", 190, good fastball. It's in the low to mid-90s, and potentially he could add some more velocity. He was the American East Pitcher of the Year, struck out 139 and 79, 2.04 ERA, just 23 walks. So he has the control, he has the stats. Teams and scouts, they might worry about his relatively small size, but he throws strikes. He shows great composure. He doesn't hit triple digits, but his fastball has some good movement. It misses bats. And considering that this is a seventh round pick, I'd say it was a fantastic pick. And yet another quality arm in the system. I love this pick, Nick Sinicola. And then in the eighth round, somehow in the eighth round, we get local Cal product Ian Villers from Walnut Creek, California. And this dude is 6'6", 245. And he was used as a reliever and an opener. He led the team with 29 appearances. He got off to a slow start, but he owned a 1.27 ERA, 4-0 record in his final 19 appearances from April 9th to May 29th. His fastball usually sits in the mid-90s, but it can hit 98 when he reaches back. And potentially he can get to triple digits, you know, as he develops. So this is a guy, he throws a pair of breaking balls. He's got a slider, cutter with a tight short action. He's got a curveball that he can throw with good depth. He's also working on a splitter that he's trying to command. He struggles at sometimes with command, speaking of that. But overall, he's seasoned, he's consistent, and he's projected as a bullpen arm. This guy can move through the system quickly, assuming he signs, because he still has one more year if he wants to go back to school. But this guy could be a scary sight out of that bullpen for opposing hitters with his size, his strength, his velocity. Ian Villers, I thought, was a fantastic pick in the eighth round. And if you thought we were done with pitchers, no. Out of Central Arizona Community College, it's Matt Olson in the ninth round. He's just 5'11 and 180. We've got a lot of big dudes in this draft. So we're going to give a smaller guy a chance here. Not that he's tiny, but like I said, 5'11". His strikeout numbers are impressive. Even though it's JC ball, still. In 2019, the last full season before that pandemic, he struck out 194 and 125, 2.09 ERA. He was drafted in 2020, fifth round, did not sign, got a fastball around 92, 93, all the typical secondary pitches, including a quality changeup. And some of his stats reported for this year include 133 strikeouts in just 88 innings, 30 walks, 2.13 ERA. That's some stats that I found on him for this year. And he is committed to Arizona State for his senior year, I believe, but the Giants took a chance on him. See if he'll go pro. Based on the stats and the scouting reports, I think it's a pretty decent gamble for Matt Olson. I don't know if he'll work out or not, but why not? Why not give this kid a shot? I mean, he's dominating in his league. Let's see if he wants to go pro right away and give him a shot. Matt Olson, right-handed pitcher. Which brings us to the last pick of the second day of the draft. In the 10th round, the Giants took Vaughn Brown, an outfielder. Hey, position players need love too. Brown is 6'1", 190. He made great improvements this season, massive improvements. He brought his batting average, which was around 250, 260, maybe 280 in the last two or three years, to 387 with a 462 on base and an incredible 1,254 OPS. He hit 13 bombs in 111 at-bats, and he's also a quality fielder. He started 34 of his 37 games played, including 22 in right, 11 in center. He doesn't have blazing speed or anything, but like I said, decent defense, good defense, and the Giants, hey, they said, why don't we take someone off the radar a little bit who looks like he came into some crazy power recently and hitting skills. We could grab him in the 10th round and just see what he can do because there is power potential. The question is it enough? Was it just a short-term hot streak? Or does this kid really have a bat that could be useful eventually at the big league level? I don't have an answer to that, but I can't wait to find out. So talking about the San Francisco Giants drafting 9 pitchers in the first 10 rounds. I love it. I love some of these guys. I really believe at least 5 of these 10 guys will make an appearance in the big leagues. I mean, I really like a lot of these names, and we'll see how that goes. That's maybe a little bit overkill there to think 5 of them will make it, but I really do like all these guys, and I think the Giants did a fantastic job. I couldn't be happier with Will Bednar, even though he wasn't on my mind because I thought he'd be going a little bit later. But once they said Will Bednar, brought a smile to my face, and I started looking into him a little more, and I said, you know what? Great job, Farhan Zaidi. I think this will work out. We'll see. But we got a ton of pitching now in the system. So if you're worried about that, worry no more. We got a lot of guys to keep an eye on. I can't wait to watch them in San Jose. I can't wait to watch them in Sacramento. Even if they don't make it to the Giants, at least we'll get to see them in the minor leagues. Pretty much all of these guys that sign. They may not all sign, but those who do sign, can't wait to watch them in the minors. So you guys have a great day. Thank you so much for the support. We just hit 10K. I can't believe it. I'm so happy. Please hit that subscribe button. Please hit that thumbs up button. Can't wait to talk to you again. Have a great day. Go Giants, and we'll see you.
When the Giants come to town, it's bye bye, baby. Every time the chips are down, it's bye bye, baby. History's in the making.